Hello everyone, welcome to We All Learn Today. I am Rajati, Assistant Professor, Department of Information Technology from Madurai Swagathi Nada's Fine Meenakshi Women's College. So in this video, we are going to discuss about C programming. So today's topic, we are going to discuss about functions in C. So first we have to know what is function, right? So a C function may or may not return a value from a function. If you don't have to return any value from the function, use void for the return type. So actually we know. So how to run the C program means actually a C program is run from the main function. So in this main function, we don't want to return any value means instead of using int main, float main and double main, we can use void mains. So void means it does not return any value. So if you want to return any value from the function means you need to use any data type such as int, long, character and etc. The return types depends on the value to be returned from the function. So this is the example of the function. So here we are using our two functions, name is hello and get. So totally two example functions. So the hello function will not return any value, that's why we are using the void data type here. And here in the second example, we are using the float data type because it returned the values in the data type is 10.2, which is a fraction part. That's why we are using the float data type. So this is the two corresponding example of the functions. One is by using the void data type and another one is float data type. So divide a large program. So first we have to know what is the purpose of functions. So the purpose is nothing but divide a large number into a small building block is known as function. The function contains the set of program statement which is enclosed by curly braces, open and close curly braces. A function can be called multiple times to provide reusability and modularity to the program. Any C program contains at least one function, that is main function. We know every program is start running from the main function. That main function is a mandatory one. So every program have at least one function, that is known as main function. And let's see the some advantages of the function. So by using the function, we can avoid rewriting same logic, same code again and again in a program. So if you are using a repeated statement means better you are using inside the function. Whenever a program is need, we can just easily call that function. We need not again and again write a code. It's avoid the rewriting. So that is the main advantage of the function. And we can call a C function any number of times in the program and from any place in the program. So we can track a large C program easily when it is divided into multiple functions. So tracking is a very, very easy. So reusability is the main achievement of a C program. So these are the types of function. So library function and the user defined function. So inside the library function, which is nothing but predefined function, already the functions are available like a main. We can just use the function. So predefined function and declared inside the header file and body inside is .dll file. So for example, we know we have a printf function and scanf function. Printf is used to printing the statement and scanf is used to getting the input from the user. And second types is user defined function, which is nothing but by the name itself, the function is defined by the user. So it's nothing but it's created by the user and reduce complexity of the program. So there are two types of function in a C program. First one is library function. So let's see one by one. So library function, which are declared in a C header file such as scanf, printf, gets, puts, seal, flow. These are the some example of the library functions. So system defined function cannot be modified. It can be only read and can be used. So these functions are supplied with every C compile. So the only restriction is the function is already there. The only we can use it. It's only readable function. We cannot do any modification on that. Okay. And second one is use defined function. The function which are created by the C programmer, which is nothing but a we. We are the user. We are only creating the function so that he or she can use it many times. It reduces the complexity of the big program and optimize the code. The user defined function define the user according to its requirement. So let's see the what are all the function aspects. So these are the function aspects. We have three aspects. One is function definition and function call and function declaration. So this is the corresponding syntax of the function definition, function call and function declaration. So let's see one by one in a brief manner. So function declaration, first one, function declaration is also known as function prototype. So the another name is function prototype. A function must be declared globally in a C program to tell the compiler about a function name, function parameter and the return type of the function. So while declaring the name of the argument is optional, and the function prototype always terminated by the semicolon. So actually the declaration of the function is optional. We can declare or else we can directly go for the definition part, because I will see later, because function declaration, the only thing is the function declaration part is end with the semicolon, which is the main thing. And this is the declaration part, how to declare a function. Okay, first float is a return type, and then find area, which is the function name. You can give any name, so not only a restriction for only give the find area, you can give any name. So first is return type and the function name, and inside this length and width, no, this is called parameter. So inside the parenthesis we have return type, again return type of the parameter, and the parameter name is length, and the second parameter type is a float, and second parameter name is width, and finally it's end with a termination with semicolon. So this is the proper way of declaration of the function. So next is a function definition. So function definition consists of whole description or and code of the function. It tells about what function is doing, what are inputs and what are the outputs. It consists two parts, function header and function body. It contains actual statement which are to be executed. So it is most important aspect to which the control comes when the function is called. So let's see one by one with the example. So this is the syntax of the function definition. So same what syntax you are seeing in a function declaration, same as it is, same syntax is here. Return type, function name, and inside the parameters we have the data type and argument 1, data type 2, argument 2, data type 3 and argument 3. So the only difference is, and before the function declaration part, we are give the semicolon at the end of the statement. But here there is no semicolon. So the same as it is in the function declaration, we are using the function definition also. But in function declaration, we are using the semicolon. Here there is no semicolon we are using. So this is the reason Actually, here when we are defining the function, here also we are using the mentioning the return type of the function. So that's why function declaration is a optional. Now it's a clear, no? So function definition is enough. Function declaration is a optional one. When you are using the functional declaration, means it should be end with a semicolon. When it comes to the function definition, there is no semicolon, because after the function header we have the body of the function. Okay, so return type, function name, data type 1 argument 1, data type 2 argument 2, data type 3 and argument 3. It's your wish, you can give any number of arguments. And after this is called function header. Okay, and note that there is no semicolon here. And after the open and close curly braces, inside this we are using the local declaration, local variable declaration, and we can give any process with the number of statement, and finally we can return a values by using the return keyword. Okay, so this is the function header and this is the function body. So this is the example, another example. So this is corresponding syntax. We are using a example here. So here int is a return type, add is a function name, and int x comma y is a parameters. In this example we are using two parameters, and inside open and curly braces the two line is a called function body, and some process is taken here, sum equal to x plus y, and we are returning that value by using the return keyword. So this is the corresponding example of function definition. Let's see about function definition. So the return type denote the types of value that function will return, and it is optional. And if it is omitted, it is assumed to be int by default. If you forget to give a data type, means by defaultly it will take on as a int data type. Okay, the body of the function is component statement or block of which consists of local variable, and declaration statement and optional return statement. So return statement is a optional one. The local variable declared inside a function is a local to that function only, so it cannot be used anywhere in the program, and its existence in only within a function. The argument of the function definitions are known as formal argument. So you just note down this formal argument. Actually we have a number of argument name, which is nothing but only two arguments. The argument is the name is different. It's based on where it is placed. Okay, so if the parameter is placed inside the function definition, means that parameter which is called as formal argument. Okay, next is we are seeing about third one, function call. So this is the last aspect. So function call, we are seeing how to declare a function, and we are seeing about how to define a function, and now we have to know how to call that function, right? So this is the third part. And function call, function can be called from anywhere in the program. So we can call anywhere, there is no restriction. The parameter list must not differ in the function call and the function declaration. So how many parameter you are using the function declaration, that many parameters we have to use while you are calling that function. Okay, so we must pass the same number of function as it is declared in the function declaration. So when the function get called by the calling function, then that is called function call. The compiler execute these functions when semicolon is followed by the function name. The argument that are used inside the function call are called actual argument. So before a slide we are seeing about formal argument, and here another one argument is here, that is nothing but actual argument. Okay, so when when argument and parameter is the same name. A parameter is inside the function call means that is called as actual argument, and if the parameter is placed inside the function definition means that argument is called formal arguments. Okay. So this is the example of the calling function. Okay. So if we know the function start from the main function. So let's see from the main void main, and after the curly braces we are using display and then end with semicolon. So this is the way we have to call the function. So directly that after that display line it will directly go down and void display, and then we have to print some values, smile, the word smile with you. Okay, some words are printing, and after that it goes back to the main function and again it print the after that print of cry, and you stop the monotony. Okay, so this is the way we have to call the function. And one more thing you just note down is only the semicolon is used when we are declaring the function and the calling the function. The semicolon is not present in the defining the function. So let's see all the function aspects in this program. So first one is function declaration. So as usual, data type and the function name and the parameters end with the semicolon. And then function call, here using the here we are just calling that function. There is no data type and it is also end with a semicolon. And this is a function definition. So inside the main function we are calling function, so directly it goes here. In function we are using three data type and then statements. So this is the full aspects, functions aspects, you know, one single program. Okay, here the function declaration is an option. We can use it or we can neglect it, there is no wrong. But function definition and function calling is an important one. Okay, let's see about in a previous slide we are discussed about the two arguments, right? Actual and formal arguments. So let's see some example and let's see what is what. So actual argument, the argument which are mentioned or used inside a function call is known as actual argument. Okay, if you are mentioning that argument is inside the function call, means it's a called actual argument, and these are the original value. So note that one, original value, that's why we are calling this as a actual argument, and copy of these actually sent to the called function. Okay, it can be written as constant, expression, and any function can like this is the example, function x, function x end with semicolon, function 20 comma 30 end with semicolon, and these are the some corresponding example. So here x 20 30 a into b c into d 2 3 sum of a comma b, these are the called as actual argument. Okay, because these arguments is present inside the function call, that's why this is called as actual argument. Okay, next is a formal argument. So we can use we can call this as a formal argument or a dummy argument. So the argument which are mentioned in the function definition. Okay, in a previous slide we have discussed about our arguments is mentioned inside the function call means it's called a actual argument. Here function definition, inside the function definition means it's called a formal or dummy argument. So these arguments are used to just hold the copy of the value that are sent by the calling function through the function call. So these arguments are like other local variable which are created when the function call starts and destroy and when a function ends. Okay, so this is the example of this is the corresponding explanations of actual and formal arguments. So this is the comparison chart. So actual argument, and here is a formal argument. Actual parameter or parameter which are calling subprogram. Here formal parameter or parameter which are in called subprogram. So there is no need to specify data type in actual parameter, but data type receive must be defined when it comes to the formal parameter. The parameter are written in function call are known as for actual parameter. Here parameters are written in a function definition is known as formal parameter. So actual parameters can be constant value or variable names. Formal parameters can be treated as a local variable of a function in which they are used in a function header. So this is the corresponding difference between actual and a formal parameters. So let's see the example. Okay, so this is the program. So here the formal parameter, why it means it's a function definition part, p and q. So p and q is a formal parameter. Here a comma b is placed inside the function called, so that's why it's called actual parameter. So this is the example of functions, overall functions. So main function, inside the main function we have a so before the main function we are just declaring the function function, and then after the main function we are declaring the local variables, and then we are just calling the function ret equal to max of a comma b. So after that line reach, it will goes down to the function definition. So here we are just processing something. So after that result, it will return that value to the result. The result value is stored in a ret value. So after that, the printf statement will be processed. So next is two way of passing arguments. Actually, we have a two way to passing that argument. We know what are all the arguments and what are the types of arguments we are seeing. Okay, so next is how to pass or how to call a arguments. Okay, so the actual argument and formal argument must match in a number, type and order. So following are two way to pass argument to the function. So first one is pass by value, second one is pass by reference. Okay, let's see one by one for the example. So original value is modified means, if modified means yes means called by reference. If there is no modification means that is called by value. Okay, this is the crucial things you just note down. Okay, so first pass by value. So in call by value or pass by value method, the value of the actual parameter is copied to the formal parameter. In other words, we can say that the value of variable is used in the function called. In the function called can be method. The function called method, we cannot modify the value of actual parameter by the formal parameter. So in call by value, different memory is allocated for actual and formal parameter. Since the value of actual parameter is copied to the formal parameter. Okay, so note down, this is the important point. Actually, in call by value, we have a different memory allocation for actual and a formal parameter. Different memory allocation, only copy of the value is sent. The actual parameter is which is used in a function called, whereas formal parameter is argument which is used in a function definition. So original value remains unchanged. There is no change in a original variable. So this is the example of call by value or a pass by value. So first one is as usual main function. We have to start from the main. So main function int x equal to 100, and then before printf x value is nothing but 100. So the first line will be printed, okay? And after that, we are just calling that function. So change x. So here the function call, it's called means it's go to the function. So void change, and before adding a value inside the function, so directly the passing a value is 100. So directly num value is 100 will be printed. So second line will be printed as it is 100. And after that line, number equal to number plus 100. So we are adding 100 to that number. And after adding that value, we are just printing the num value. Here, third line will be printed after adding inside the function number equal to 200. Because 100 plus 100 is 200. Okay. So after process done, it again backs to the main function. So after that printf statement, after function call, here x value is 100. There is no change because that adding value is changed once it is only reflected in the function only. When it comes to the main function, there is no change. Okay, x value is as it is because it has different memory location for formal and actual parameter. Okay. So this is another example of call by and pass by arguments with swapping. In before first example, we are just changing that value by using some calculations, just adding. And now we are just using the function. So let's see this example. It's like a swapping. So int a equal to 10, b equal to 20, and then swap. Before swapping, we are just printing a value and b value. It's nothing but a equal to 10, b equal to 20. And after swapping a comma b, so this is a calling function. So this is swap a comma b means it's just call that function. So after that function process, it again goes here, goes back to main function and printing the last line after swapping main a comma b. Okay. So next. The function swap function, here we are just declaring one temporary variable and we are just exchanging that variable. Okay, a temp equal to a equal to b, b equal to temp. So now after swapping, we have changed that value. A value is 20 and b value is 10. Okay, and after that all processed completed, it again go back to the main function, and that main function we have a swapping function printing line a value and b value. There is no change. See, the output of the first line is same as output of the third line. So 10 20 10 20. Okay, so any changes, if you are doing any changes, any modification like changing a value or some processing a value, add multiple division, any changes you are done means that changes will not affect in the main function. So that this is the example, clear example of call by value or pass by value. Okay, so we are seeing with two example we are done with call by value. Next we will discuss about pass by reference. Okay, so in call by reference, the address of the variable is passed into the function call as the actual parameter. So the value of the actual parameter can be modified by changing the formal parameters since the address of actual parameter is passed. In call by reference, the memory allocation is similar for both formal and actual argument. Please note down, this is the another one important concept. Because when we are seeing about call by value, here both memory allocation is different for different memory allocation for formal parameter and actual parameter. But when it comes to the call by reference, we have a memory location, same memory location is for both formal and actual parameters. So obviously the changes will be modified. Okay, the original value, if you are doing any changes, means the original value will be affected. That is the main concept here, because it share the same memory location. So all the operation in the function are performed on the value stored at the address of the actual parameter, and the modified value gets stored at the same address. Okay, so let's see the same example. So what we are seeing in the previous call by values is the same example we are taken here for the clear understanding. So same, so the only thing is we have to use when we are calling that function, we are using the ampersand symbol, and when we are using the function definition, here we are using the asterisk symbol. So there is no change. The only difference is we are using the ampersand symbol and the asterisk. So this is called a reference. Okay, here we are just trying to change that value. So same, the 100 and then 100. So first main function, we are declaring x value is 100. So x value is printed before function call. The first output of the first line is printed. Okay, after that we are calling that function change. So it goes back to the function change and print off. Before adding function, number value is 100. There is no change because we are not did any process here. So same 100 is printed here. Second line will be printed. So after that we are have the process line, number plus equal to 100. So what is the meaning of this line? Means actually plus equal to is nothing but shorten assignment operator. Actually we are discussed about in operator statement, we had this is called shorten assignment. So what is the meaning is number plus equal to 100 means number equal to number plus 100. So what is the number? 100. So 100 plus 100 is equal to 200. So printf is after adding value inside function, we have 200. Okay, so after done the all process of the function, it again goes back to the main function. Here we have the printf function. After function call, we have now x value is 200. Okay, the original value will be changed because both formal and actual argument is share the same memory location. So if you are done any changes, means it will be reflect to the original one. So this is the main concept of the function. Okay, so in a call by value we are seeing two type of example. So here call by reference, I am just taking the same two types. One is call by value by using the increasing a values. Now it's a swapping, the same we are what we are seeing in a function called by value, the same example. So the only thing is we are using called by using ampersand, and then we have to use in the asterisk function definition. Okay, so this is the corresponding example. So the 10 20 20 10 means after the main function again 20 10, there is no change. Actually it's a modified. Okay, because it will share the same memory location. That is the reason if you are do any modification in that variable, means it reflect. That is the main concept here. Okay, so this is the difference between a call by value and a call by reference. So a copy of value is passed into the function. Okay, so here an address of the value is passed to the function. Address is nothing but we are using ampersand symbol, right? So that is called address. And here changes made inside the function is limited to the function only. The value of the actual parameters do not change by changing the formal parameter. So what we are, if you are doing the changes, right, x equal to 100 and swapping that value 10 20 20 10, so the process is only present inside the function. it will not affect the main function. But when it comes to the call by reference, changes made inside the function valid outside of the function also. The values of the actual parameter do change by changing a formal parameter. Okay, so the reason is actual and formal parameters are created at the different memory location in a call by value, but when comes into the call by reference, actual and formal arguments are created at the same memory location. So this is the reason for reflecting. Okay, so this is the exact what is what and call by value and call by reference. I hope you clearly about what is call by value, what is call by reference with a corresponding two example. Actually, I am taking two similar example. I am not changing, I am not giving a different example for call by value and call by reference. I am just taking the two type of same example for call by value and call by reference. One is adding 100 and another one is swapping. Same swapping I am just taking for both call by one, call by reference, because then only you can clearly understand. That is the reason I am just taking that same example. Okay, so we are discussed about from the starting, right? So in a first slide, we are discussed about what is function. Okay, actually what is function? What is the purpose of function and why we have to use the function, and then function aspects. We have seen about three function aspects, right? Function definition, function declaration, function call. So these function three aspects is we are seeing with what is what and syntax with example. And after that, we are discussed about two arguments. Okay, one is formal argument and another one is actual argument. We are seeing both in a with a what is what, syntax and example, and finally we are seeing about how to call a function, how to call by value and call by reference. Okay, and the final one is category of function. So let's see, these are the some category of function. Function with no argument, no return value. Function with no argument but return value. Function with argument but no return value. Function with argument and return value. So before getting into the topic, we have to know what is function. So previous up to this, we are cleared about what is function, right? So now we have to know what is argument and what is return type. Actually, you are cleared about it. I'm just recollecting you. Argument is nothing but inside the parenthesis we are giving some variables, so that variables is called arguments. So the argument place is based on the placing of the arguments. We have the name is formal argument and the actual argument, right? So if it is of variable names inside the function call, means it's called a actual argument. If it is a place in the function definition, means it's a formal argument. So anyway, argument is nothing but inside the, after that function name, we have using the parenthesis, right? So open and close parenthesis. Inside, we are, if we are using any variable, means that variable is called arguments. If there is no argument, means we have to use empty parenthesis. Okay? And then return value. Return value is nothing but we have to return something. We are writing, we have to return some values, means we have to use return keyword. And one more thing, when we are getting that return value, means that calling function, no, that calling function, we have to use a separate variable for that. Okay, if you are clearly understand what is argument return value means, this is very, 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 very easy concept. Okay, let's see one by one with the example. Okay, so first one is function with no argument and no return value. So by the name itself, this function contains there is no argument, no return value, which means no argument. It only have empty parentheses and no return value. There is no keyword present in the name of return. Okay, so to create a function with no argument and no return value, we set the parameter list to void and return type to the function to the void, which is nothing but there is no return value. So we can use the data type name is a void. So function without argument and without return values. So this is the calling function and called function, and this is the analysis process. So in the main function, we are just calling the function. So no argument passed to the called function, and there is no value sent back to the calling function. Okay, no return value is here. So this is the skeleton of the what process is going on. So let's see the example for the clear understanding. So this is the example. So inside the main function, we are using void sum. Why we are using the void? Because there is no using return value. There we are not returning any value. Okay, that's why we are using the void. So void sum of the end with semicolon. This is a function declaration part, and then clear screen sum of. This is a function call. The third line is a function call. After this line, it will goes to the function name. So void sum of local variable declaration, and we are just getting two numbers from the user, and we are just processing value c equal to a plus b, and the value is printed directly here. The c value is not passed to there. Okay, no. Only the printf statement is here. So after that function finished, it again go back to the main function. Here only the get c is. So output will be printed. Okay. So see the example. There is no argument. So the parenthesis is empty, and then no return value. There is no keyword name is return. Okay. Next is a function with no argument but return value. Okay, so function with no argument, which means the same. In a previous example, we have seen empty parenthesis. Same empty parenthesis is used here also, but return value. Okay. For this example, we have void in a parameter list, but we set the return type to match the type value written by the function. Function without argument and with return value. So it's going to return something. So we have to use data type, any other data type instead of void. So this is the skeletons. So we are just using that main function. There is no argument is passed here because empty parenthesis. And see the called function, we are using the return keyword. So values are sent back. Okay. Values with no argument but return value. So example is main function, we are using the function declaration, variable declaration. We are just calling that function by using the another variable. So this is the way we are seeing before. So if we are using return keyword, means we have to use the new variable c equal to sum, because return means it will return some value to that main function. Okay, so for and here we have to hold some value for that getting the value. So that's why we are using the c value, c equal to sum of. So sum of means it goes back to the function, sum function. So here no arguments is passed. Okay, sum of is empty parenthesis, there is no variable is passed, only the process is done, declaration part and getting two values from the user, and the c equal to a plus b. And after that process, we are not using the printf statement, we are just give return c. This value is passed to the c function, and then here printf value is present only in the main function. Okay, so here no argument is passed but return value. Here we are not using the void, because we are returned some values, that's why we are using some data type. Okay, this function with argument and no return value. With argument means we know obviously there is no empty parenthesis, but no return value means okay, there is no return keyword is placed. So in this type of the function, we have return type set to void, but parameter list is set to accept some argument. So function with argument without return value. So this is the skeleton. So function is the argument is passed to the called function, and there is no value is sent back to the main function. This is the example. So inside the main function, we are just declaration of the function and variable, and getting two value from the user, and just calling that function a comma b, and then after inside the main function, we are just declaring a new variable, and then processing is done, and printing statement is also done here. Okay, so the passing two argument is passed, but it will not return any value. Okay, so here we are using two argument a comma b. So this is the example of function with argument and no return value. There is no return keyword is used. Okay, and next is function with argument and with return values. So in the, this is the final category of the function. Actually, we are seeing this is the last one. So the function with argument with return value, both are present here. So in this data type, with argument means obviously there is no empty parenthesis. Something, some variables are placed inside the parenthesis. This is the first concept you have to understand. And the second one is with return type. So obviously it will return something, it will return some values. Okay, so that's why we have to use return keyword, and we should not use void here because it returns something. Okay, so this is the two main concept you have to understand, right? So in this type of the function, we set both parameter list and return type. So function with return arguments with arguments and with return value, this is the skeleton. So calling function, so argument has passed to the called function and values are sent back to the main function. Okay, here the return keyword is used. Okay, once you are clearly about the skeleton means, the example and the understanding is very very easy. Let's see with the example. So hash include stdio.hash main function. This is a function declaration part, and then variable declaration, and then we are getting two values from the user, and just we are creating that variable for calling that function a comma b. So the function is called here. So what values we are getting from the user? So 3, 5 means the 3, 5 a value is taken 3 and b value is taken 5. So int c equal to a plus b means 3 + 5 is equal to 8. So here directly we are not printing that value. Instead, we are just returning that value to the main function. Okay. So in that main function, we are just catching that c to the main function, and the printf statement is placed only inside the main function. Okay. So this is the example of function with argument and with return value. So here we are using two argument, and in sum of a comma b. So inside the main function we are using a comma b, that argument no. So that argument is called actual argument, and here function definitions we have a comma b, right? So this function argument is called formal argument. So formal means it's a dummy argument. Actual means it's a original argument. So this is the way we have to categorize the function. Okay, so only based on the argument and the return values, we are just category the function. So we are seeing about four categories. One is function with argument with return value, function with argument no return value, function with no argument return value, function with no argument no return value. So four categories are complete. Okay, so I hope you clear about all those concept. So actually I will just I want to summarize from the first. Okay, I hope you are understand about function concept, because this only one video I'm just covering all those function topics. So for that reason I'm just recollecting once again. So in the first, what is function? Function means the main purpose is we have to reduce the length code. Okay, so to reduce the program length for reusable concept, the function is plays the main role. Okay, so this is the function and why we have to use, means this is the purpose. Okay, and let's see, we have seen about the syntax, and then we are discussed about some function aspects. Okay, so in the function aspects, we have seen how three aspects: function definition, function declaration, and then function call. How to declare a function, how to define a function, how to call a function. So in a function call and function declaration, we have to use semicolon, right? We have to end with a semicolon. In the function definition, there is no need to use a semicolon, because we have the body of the function, right? Okay, so function, these are the some three aspects. So the three aspects is clearly mentioned, and after that we are seeing about two arguments, right? One is formal arguments and another one is actual argument. So formal arguments, we have we can call this as a dummy argument actually, because only copy of the original value is sent here. So that's why it's called a formal argument. And another one is actual argument. So what are the argument we are used inside the function called? That argument is called actual argument. So we can call this as a original argument. Actually, this is the original value. Okay. So and next one is we are discussed about how to pass a value or how to pass an argument. Okay, so actually how to pass an argument means the two way, call by value and then call by reference. So the call by value means we have to call that value, and then here both formal and actual parameters are memory location is different when we are using the call by value, because call by value we have a different location, different memory location for formal and actual arguments. So if you have done any addition operation, or if you want to swapping values, any process you are done means it will not reflect to the main function, because the storage place is different. Okay, and then next one is a call by reference. So call by reference is nothing but it will share the same memory location actually. So that's why if you are doing something, if you are done any process, means it will reflect the main function also. Okay, so because formal and actual parameters are used in the same memory location, that's why if you have done any changes, for example adding or swapping, it will reflect to the main function too. Okay, so for that clear better studying, I'm just taking same example. Okay, and the next one is category of functions. So category of function means here we have discussed about four functions. Okay, so that four function is nothing but return value and arguments. How to pass a argument without return type, with the argument with return value. Okay, so we have discussed about the categories of a function with the corresponding examples. Okay, and the next one is we have to know function types. So there is two types: predefined function and user defined function. So predefined function is nothing but library function. We can call this as a library function or predefined function. Okay, so actually we have a many number of predefined functions we know. For example, printf, scanf, getsof, putsof, getcareof, putcareof, and one more thing, the main function. Every program have at least one function that is nothing but main function. Okay, so after that we are using that main function. So this is a predefined function. Okay, so predefined function, if you are using a predefined function, means you have to know one thing, it's only readable one. You cannot do any modification. It's only readable concept. Actually, it's a predefined one. You can only use it wherever you are using. Okay, so for that only we have to include the header file, corresponding header file we have to include, because all the predefined function is stored inside the header file, corresponding header file. For example, why we are using stdio.h? Actually, for getting input and output, which is nothing but that stdio.h header file contains printf and scanf function. Okay, so the printf and scanf function, it placed inside the stdio.h header file. If you want to use math.h, for example, mathematical function, if you want to use, means for example, seal of, floor of, and square root of, power of. So these are the some mathematical functions. These are the mathematical function. It's also called as library function or predefined function. If you want to use a mathematical function like sqrt, which means square root of, power of, or seal of, floor of. So if you want to sine of, cos of, tan of, okay, so these are the some list of mathematical functions. If you want to use these function, means before that you have to declare math.h header file. Okay, and one more thing, we have a library function or predefined function named gets of input and output functions, and then this is a mathematical function. And the next one is nothing but string function. So if you can copy a string and paste the string, you can join a string, and then so reverse the string, count the length of the string. Okay, these are the some string functions is also present, which is actually in the string function strrev for reverse, strcat concatenation, str and then cpy for copy the function. Okay, so we have a plenty of string function. So if you want to use that function, means before that we have to include the string dot h header file. Okay, so this is the main actually the math dot h, string dot h, we have a I will put a separate video for that, then only you can clearly understand. The only thing is we have to listen to all those list up, and then we have to study the corresponding syntax, and we have to simply use it. We cannot modify that function actually. And next one is user defined function. For the user defined function only, that full video is done. Actually, for the user defined function, we have to know how to declare, how to call, how to process, right? So for that user defined function only, which is nothing but it's created by user. User, you can give any name, you can give your own name too, that is no issue. You can the deciding of the number of parameters and the return values, return type and the function name, everything is based on the user. That's why it's called a user defined function. Okay, so many functions are available. I hope in this video we clearly about what is function. So if you want to discuss about function means, I hope this video will be helpful. So in this one video we are discussed about functions and everything, types of the function and then category of the function and then types of the function and then aspects of the function. Okay, so I hope in this one video it's enough. So if you want to know about string function and mathematical function means, you just comment below. I will create another video for that, separate string function and then mathematical function, because we have plenty of string functions and the mathematical functions. So abs of, in the mathematical we have abs of and seal and then float and then square root. You can use the square root, sqrt, and then power of, you have to use power of means pow, and then open and close curly brace, you have to mention that value 4,2. So 4,2 means 4 power 2. Okay, so these are the some mathematical functions, and then sine of, cos of, tan of. Okay, so these are so for mathematical function we have to corresponding mathematical header file we have to include. For string we have a plenty of string reverse, string copy and string concatenation, and count the number of letters in the string. Okay, so for the string function we have to include the string.h header file. I hope this video will be helpful. If you have any doubt in this video means, you just comment below. And thank you for watching.